So here the question is find the optimal solution for the given transportation problem by using modified distribution method. So here the given problem contains three supply points and four demand points. And if you observe this particular problem, the total supply here, the total supply is 1100 and the total demand is 1000. So the demand is actually less than the supply, or supply is greater than the demand. The demand is how much less? It is 100 units less. So here I have to add 100 units, which means I have to add an extra row. So as you can observe here, we have added an extra row, and it was a demand was 100 less. So here we have added an 100 units, and then all other cell values we have to set as zero. Now we have converted the unbalanced transportation problem to a balanced transportation problem. Now the next step is to obtain initial basic feasible solution. Here for this problem, we have obtained the initial basic feasible solution by using Ogle's approximation method, and this already you are familiar with this approach. So if I want to allocate resources to any particular cell, I have to first compute the row penalties and column penalties, and then finally I have to obtain the initial solution. So now again, so here and the next step, okay, and the next step we have to check for a degeneracy. So here, as you can observe, there are totally seven allocated cells are there. So we are checking for a degeneracy. Number of allocated cells is seven, and the number of allocated cells is greater than or equal to m plus n minus 1, that is 7 greater than or equal to 3 plus 4 minus 1, which satisfies the condition, and hence there is no degeneracy in this particular problem. So now after checking for the degeneracy, the next step is to compute the costs of both allocated cells and unallocated cells. We know like all allocated cells have to satisfy this condition, that is ui plus vj is equal to cij, and all unallocated cells have to satisfy this condition, that is dij is equal to cij minus of ui plus vj. So here so how many allocated cells are there here? So we know there are totally seven allocated cells. So for this particular problem, we have to compute the ui and vj values. So for this problem, we set the value of v1 as zero. If I set the value of u1 as a zero, then this condition will not be satisfied by all the allocated cells. So for this problem, what we do, we set the value of v1 as 0. So v1, let us set the value of v1 as 0. So and this one, this will be v2, this will be v2, and this particular value will be v3. And this value will be v4, and this value will be u1. So u3, we have to compute these values. So we have to compute these values. So here the condition is v1 plus something that should be equal to this particular 3. So like here, what I have to add, okay, here I have to add 3. Okay, now as you can see, 3 plus 0 is equal to 3. Okay, since see this v1 corresponds to column S, right? This corresponds to column. So now I have to check whether is there any allocation in this particular column S. No, right? So now we go to the next column. In the next column, already we know u1 value is 3. So what should be the value for v2? It should be 1. So it should be 1, 3 plus 1 is equal to this particular value. And now, is there any allocations in this column? Yes, there are two more allocations in this column. So there is this allocation. Consider this allocation. Here the value of V2 is already 1. So what should be the value of U3? So it should be 2. It should be 2, 2 plus 1, which is equal to 3. And when you come this, say this is another allocation, yes, right? Here the value is 0. So what value I have to assign for U4 such that U4 plus V2 is equal to this particular value? So here I have to assign a value minus 1. And now consider this particular column. In this column, we have two allocated cells. Both the allocated cells should satisfy the condition, that is ui plus vj is equal to cij. So for the first cell, already we know the value for u1, it is 3. So assign a value 1 for v3. Now this satisfies the condition. Now, is there any allocation in this particular column? Yes, we have one more allocation. So for this cell, already we know the value of V3, it is 1. So U2 should be 3. So now move on to the next column. In the next column, we have only one allocation. So here the value of U2, it is already 3. So what should be the value of this V4? So we should have a value 2, right? Here I should have a value minus 1. So now, as you can observe, all the allocated cells are satisfying this condition. So now we have, so how many unallocated cells are there? In the first row, we have one cell. In the second row, we have two cells. In the third row, we have three cells. In the last row, we have three cells. So again, this particular cell, okay, this particular cell corresponds to D14. Okay, D14. So now here I have to compute. What is the Cij value here? It is 5. And what are the ui and vj values here? It is 3 and minus 1. So here you will get a value 3. So coming to the second row, here we have unallocated cell D21. So D21. So what is the cost? The cost is 3. And what are the ui and vj values? It is 3 and 0. So here you will get a 0 value. So and the next unallocated cell is D22. And here the cost, it is given as 5. And what are the ui and vj values? It is 3 and 1. So here you will get a value 1. And coming to the third row, here we have another unallocated cell, that is D31. The cost is 4. Ui and vj values are 2 and 0. So here the value is 2. Again, D33 is also unallocated cell. The cost is 4. Ui and vj values are 2 and 1. So here also you get a positive value. Now, so even for this particular cell, the cost is 3. Ui and vj values are 2 and minus 1. So again, here also you will get a positive value. So here the cost is 0. Ui and vj values are minus 1 and 0. So here you will get positive 1. So here the actual cost is 0. ui and vj values are minus 1 and plus 1. So here you will get a value 0. So again here the cost. Okay, the cost is 0. The cost is 0. And ui and vj values are minus 1. So which is equal to positive value 2. Now here you can observe, okay, all the dij values are positive values, which means we have to stop here. So now we have to compute the cost. Now if I compute the cost, if I compute the total cost, so the total cost is 3 into 200 plus 4 into 100 plus 5 into 50 plus 4 into 250 plus 2 into 200 plus 3 into 200 plus 0 into 100. So here you will get a total cost, it is 3200. So this is the optimal solution.